Hey, Atlas is back. I know, to be logs in 48 hours. Hey, what up, Atlas? There's a war on Americans, that's what up. Wanted to give you the latest. So I'm sure you saw Nancy Pelosi, Nazi Pelosi. I'm calling her a Nazi, ooh. It's only what they've been doing for the past 20 years. Okay, so she says that she can't address it because there are swastikas there.
They're asked her to be the judge of carrying swastikas and symbols like that.
Let me just show you what the swastika was that she was referring to. Okay, it's a kid. It's a kid with the Nazi symbol with a no fascism here across it. I think that's gorgeous, don't you? I think that kid is being well-schooled. Probably a homeschool child. For shiz. Versus when they use the Nazi symbol, the leftists, take a look. Okay, so you've seen that. Now, I want to discuss something else with you, just to show you how the machine works, and there really is an organized, manufactured machine, a campaign in the war against America. There is a conspiracy against America. Yes, you're living it. And the only reason why you're paying attention now, I will tell you why, is because you are the target. Because it has disrupted the daily fabric of your life. And for those of us that have been chronicling it and screaming, yeah, I understand that it didn't affect you. So you were allowed to slumber. But I am so, for the first time in years, I have to tell you, I'm optimistic. America, this is not France. This is not Indonesia. This is not one of Obama's beloved enemy countries. This is America. And we're not going to stand for this. There's no way you're going to take over this country, and we're going to do nothing about it. Let's get back to the point. So, as soon as Pelosi makes this slanderous allegation against the good people voicing their dissent, what happens? The machine revs up, and you have the Huffington Post, or as I affectionately call her, the Puff Ho, running photos of a boy, lovely young man. His crime was, he was born in Wasilla. He told a newscaster that. That was it, he was dead. Already the implication is, he's from Sarah's hometown, he's a Nazi, she's a Nazi, he's a Nazi, she's a Nazi, they're a Nazi, we're a Nazi. Wouldn't you like to be a Nazi too? Nazi Pelosi, yeah, Nazi Pelosi, Nazi Pelosi. Okay. So what do? And I'm going to show you the screenshots. I have the screenshots because I want that young lad to contact me because we're going to sue. They crop out, he's holding a sign. Like they can crop me now and say I'm giving the Nazi salute. That's what they do. They cropped out the sign and they said it was a Hitler salute. Get it? Yeah. You need to know what you're up against. These people are dirty, they play dirty, they intend to get control of 20% of the American economy. That's healthcare. That's what they want. They want control of that. And what else do they want? They want energy. Why do they want energy? Another huge chunk of the American economy. Chunk. I know, you don't want me to play with my hair. Please, if you like me, you like me to play with my hair. Chunk of the American economy, cap and trade. What is cap and trade but crap and tax? What they won't do, what the Goracle, Al Gore, won't do, is he will not tie cap and trade into actual warming. You see, Ross McKittrick, who was a leading scientist in this, if they were to tie actual global warming, you with me, to the taxation, you know what would happen? You'd be getting a rebate. And that ain't never gonna happen. Get it? Never gonna happen. Cap and trade is a tax on the working man to subsidize, believe it or not, the affluent. Yes. How is that? Because energy-dependent states will be penalized, and so Miami, Ohio, will be subsidizing Miami, Florida. That's what cap and trade is. And the last thing, of course, is education. Education. You with me? They would love that. They want to inculcate your children's minds. They want to marinate their minds in their leftist nonsense. You think they're going to teach them that 100 million people died outside of war in communist countries? Outside of war, 100 million people? Do those utopians ever talk about that? Back to the war on America. The conspiracy against America. What you're seeing is, they're calling it manufactured. Now, what if I tell my people, hey, you got to go to this rally? Is that manufactured? And by the way, is there anything wrong with that? And who is really manufactured? Look at our signs. There's grandma with her magic marker, you know, euthanasia with a red X against it. And look at their signs. And that organization, Healthcare Now, or I'll run a link to it, that is moveon.org, that is Soros, that's that group of bandits that are General Sherman against the free world. They are just slashing and burning. So I'm warning you on this, but this is an assault on everybody. It's an assault on the individual. They want to get you to stop. Do you want to be called a Nazi? No, you're a decent human being, but you're not up against decent human beings. You're up against a depraved, moralist group of cretins. And they're very serious. And I have to say that I've never been more optimistic. Your congressmen are home. Go. Go. Go online. Ask grandchildren who probably voted for Obama and were suffering at their hand. You tell them, you know what, kid? I'm not paying for your school anymore. You're going to pull this nonsense? You're going to bankrupt me? I'm not paying for your school and your fancy clothes, your little apartment, wherever you're staying, yada, yada. Really. We let the maroons decide. And now we're suffering. We want hope. And we want change, and we're going to get it. So you saw what the president said. I am the president. I am the president. Yeah.
I'm the president. I'm the president. I'm the president. Because I'm the president. But
he said if they push back, punch him harder. Who is this man? Who talks like that? What president talks like that? Didn't anybody give him a job description? Forget about the eligibility requirements. Did anybody give him a job description like, you represent all the people. You represent America in the world. You represent American hegemony. Why do you think we have so much power, asshat? Why do we have so much power? Because we're the biggest, the brightest, the best military, but you deride, but you dismiss. You think you're a big shot walking in the world if you ain't got that? You represent our power. We don't represent you. You represent us. You're the icon for the greatness of America. Stop destroying it. America, stand up. Stand up and fight. Get the folks out there. Get the good folks out there. You're not going to get your news from the TV. Even Fox. You see O'Reilly wrote a piece for Parade magazine. Why Obama is the one to. I don't know what the hell happened to that man. Not that he was ever good, but he's really gone over to the dark side. Maybe they're doing it to balance Beck, who's been totally all over it. Tip of the old hat to Glenn Beck. But you've got to go to the net for news. For us, this is a good thing. You're forcing people to the net. And so they're going to rallies, and they're going to try and catch you. They're going to pretend that they're friendly. They're going to infiltrate the rally and say, oh, tell us why you're here. And they're going to snip your comment. So don't say anything stupid. Don't be like them. I'm not telling you to quiet down. No way, no how. I see those people on the right saying, we're not behaving. Shut up, okay? Those people are old, tired, finished. The old guard, it's over. The conservatives are going to take over the party. Take over the left. When they were in shambles, remember when they were in shambles? Lost the House, lost the Senate, lost the White House. Who would have thought that the crazies, when I started chronicling this in 2005, and they had their Hitler signs with Bush, and they had their, 9/11, we deserved it. It was like, oh, shocking. And then who would have expected a couple of years later that it would become the meme, that it would become the mainstream left? That's what happened. So the evil took over their party, because it's rooted in evil anyway. Let the good take over our party. Let the good take over the Republicans, the rational, the logical, the capitalists. You know, the source of good in the world. We're going to sue anybody that tries to slander us. If they're going to fight hard, we fight back too, with morals, with integrity. You know, it's one last thing I'm just going to say. It's interesting to watch this. It's interesting to see how they're depicting us. And you're like, so that's so not us. That's what they do with Israel. Just so that you know. I know you're going to say, you're going to bring it to Israel now? This is Israel. conducts the most humane war. They send out flyers. They call people. We're gonna take out the missile launcher in your living room. And they warn the people so they can get out. And they are accused of all kinds of war crimes.